The Union Finance Minister Arun Jaitley announced on February 15th that the Most Favoured Nation status given to Pakistan stands withdrawn in the wake of the heinous terrorist attack in Pulwama district of Jammu and Kashmir the previous day, which left over 39 CRPF personnel dead. Jaish-e-Mohammed claimed responsibility for the attack. I am Lakshman Maaheshwary, and today I am going to explain the concept of Most Favoured Nation and its implications on India-Pakistan trade. The concept of Most Favoured Nation is a concept of contradiction. So what is the Most Favoured Nation status? Article 1 of General Agreement on Tariffs and Trades, GATT, of 1994 requires every WTO member country to accord MFN status or preferential trade terms with respect to tariffs and trade barriers to all other member countries. This means trade without discrimination. It is also a priority in the General Agreement on Trade in Services, GATS, which comes under Article 2, and the Agreement on Trade-Related Aspects of Intellectual Property Rights, TRIPS, which comes under Article 4. Together, these three agreements cover all three main areas of trade handled by WTO or World Trade Organization. Under the WTO agreements, countries cannot normally discriminate between their trading partners. For example, if you grant someone a special favor, such as a lower custom duty rate, you will have to do the same for all the other WTO members. Now let us examine India's stand with regard to MFN. In accordance with the obligations under the WTO, India accorded Pakistan Most Favoured Nation status in 1996. However, Prime Minister Narendra Modi had put the status under review after the Uri attacks in 2016. Talking about Pakistan, it never fully transitioned MFN status for India. On November 2, 2011, the Pakistani cabinet decided formally to accord India MFN status. However, till date, the decision remains unimplemented. In November 2018, Pakistan government official had said they did not have any immediate plans to grant India the status, but they were working on free trade agreements with many countries, including China. Presently, Pakistan maintains a negative list of 1,209 products that are not allowed to be imported from India. It permits only 138 products to be imported through Wagah-Atari border land route. But cargo trucks from either side cannot move beyond their border zones, and goods must be transloaded at the border, adding to the time and cost of trading. In practice, many of these items in the negative list are exported from India to Pakistan through a third country, usually the United Arab Emirates. Despite these restrictions, India continues to maintain a substantial trade surplus with Pakistan. Even during the times of heightened tensions and terrorist attacks sponsored by Pakistan, India never wavered from the WTO commitment. As late as December 19, 2018, in response to a query in Rajya Sabha on the withdrawal of MFN status to Pakistan, the Junior Commerce and Industry Minister had told Rajya Sabha in a written reply, "No decision has been taken to review the MFN status accorded to Pakistan so far." But after the Pulwama attack, the things changed. The decision by India to withdraw MFN status to Pakistan is intended to isolate Pakistan diplomatically and squeeze the country's industry. Now let us examine the impact of withdrawal of MFN. India can now enhance custom duties to any level on goods coming from Pakistan. India and Pakistan are involved in bilateral trade in commodities and goods, including sugar, cement, chemicals, dyes, cotton, iron and steel, vegetable and fruits, mineral fuels and salts. Pakistan cannot do much since it never offered India MFN status. However, even if India imposes punitive duties on goods, it is not going to impact Pakistan much. The trade value is very low. At best, the move by the government has more of symbolic value. Let us examine the bilateral trade figures. According to a World Bank report, the current level of trade between Pakistan and India is valued a little over $2 billion. This is about only 0.35% of India's overall trade. The potential capacity is much higher at $37 billion. In contrast, India's trade with much smaller Bhutan is over half that with Pakistan. In 2016, total India-Bhutan bilateral trade was at ₹8,723 crores, while with Pakistan, it was around 17,200 crores. Even though the low volumes of trade limits the impact that such a step can have, the stoppage of input materials such as chemicals and cotton from India will push up the cost of production for the relevant Pakistani industries. At the same time, it can have some unwanted impact as well. It would give a push to the illegal trade between the two countries, which takes place through border gaps and via third countries. It could also give a handle to extremist elements in Pakistan to scale up the rhetorics against India. The long-term impact remains to be seen. This video was about the most favored nation status and its implication on India-Pakistan trade and was brought to you by Lakshman Maheshwary. Keep our slain brave hearts in your prayers.